Okay, welcome back. Still have Barrister Tony Ofoyetan and Colonel Michael Oladeji, retired. We're looking at the general probe against corruption, probe into corruption, and then in particular we're sort of narrowing in on the military and the challenges there. The military must be loyal. That's the democracy requires that. It must be loyal to the constituted civilian authority. But we've just heard how in there, whereas we expect to have a professional military, we also expect to have an upright, morally, correct civilian authority. So you have these two, and both of them are assuming that. The civil authority, the moral high civil authority, is imagining that it can depend on the discipline, professionalism, training, knowledge of the military. And the military is expecting all the while that this guy is going to be doing only what is morally correct and won't be giving me any bad orders. But should they come, you say that's now a problem. How are you, if a person determines that this is corrupt, this is out of order, you're saying that it seems, and let me go to the colonel for this, you would say that it's a problematic area and it's not a matter of in recent times, that it's been with us for decades.
Exactly. It's been with us for decades.
But it somehow has never been as bad as for it to be showing the way we have begun to think we have seen it. Because I'll wait on the panel, administrative panel, to come up with our own, their own findings. But the way it seems is that the military can be used.
Maybe because like the Dasuki gate has not shown up in the past. That's why people don't know that it's been with us.
But you think corruption has been spilling out from the civilian into the military for decades?
For decades. Whatever, like I said, whatever happens to the military today, the politicians, the civilians are involved. Go to our civil service.
Even if they're involved, are they responsible as a result?
They are, okay. In a way. They are. Yeah.
How can you say that? With due respect, sir. With due respect, Colonel.
No, the civilians.
The civilian cannot be responsible for the corruption. Mm-hmm.
Wait.
I'll give you right of reply.
Look at our civil service. That is the hallmark of corruption in Nigeria.
Well, I'm sure the Civil Service Association of Nigeria, if there's any such body, will be very unhappy about that.
But you're saying that
these things need to be said.
Yes, you understand.
Well, this is the problem. For those who are saying that we're going on too much about corruption, there you are saying there's still the whole civil service aspect.
But we have to fight it.
That we haven't even got to.
Yes,
Tony said earlier,
we're
at the tip of the iceberg and we're making all these noise.
We have to fight it. If we really want to get to where we want to get to.
Well, I think with due respect, the issue of fighting corruption, I think, like you said, it's so, I don't know whether to say genetic, because I know that as a young boy in life, I remember the era of 4 million naira check flying from the aircraft, Diko. When we were very young, we're hearing such stories like that 4 million naira check flew and disappeared. We've heard of the Gulf scandal, oil scandal. We've heard of so many scandals, even the Okoti Airbus and the like, in this country. If you look at the history of corruption in this country, right from independence, you'll see that it's so endemic in this country that I don't see a situation where within 4 years, anybody will be able to, achieve something very big. But the advantage is that, like we all agree, it lays a foundation, it lays a consciousness. But I think that beyond that, I'm looking at a situation where the government will go straight down to the children now, to those that are young now. Because between you and
to show that this is not the way people should be,
if you look at the society we are now, even within our street, you see small boys belonging to cult, you see small boys, wanting to ride porch cars at very terrible age.
Again, exactly.
They want to walk without crawling.
It's just all over the place. The point is, we were looking at not exclusively the military, but all these things you're saying, and the colonel has said that this thing has been with us for ages. But it's only in recent times that we began to see millionaire military officers, by which I mean farms.
People living in affluence.
The kind of Spartan. Look, a general is a general. He's never going to be a poor person. But so there's a certain level. But there are military people that are almost look like princes in the way they live and in terms of what they have. This is a relatively recent phenomenon. Perhaps you'll agree. I'll let you come back to that when I come back from Mr. Odedeyi. And thank you very much for holding on. Go ahead, please.
Good morning, Uncle Yori.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning to the panelists in the house.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm indeed very worried about the way we are going about corruption in this country. I listened to quite a number of people ever since this latest gate broke out, and what I've been hearing is quite disheartening. You know, people who are supposed to be educated, people who are supposed to be human rights activists, what they were talking about is, why is this man coming out now? Why has he not come out before now?
Okay, you're referring there to Dr.
Yes.
What's that gentleman's
Aluko.
Name?
Aluko.
Dr. Tokwe Aluko, the former PDP secretary in Ekiti State.
Instead of talking about the merit of his case, most people have just been talking about the character of the person.
Yeah.
If he had been given what he wanted, would he have come out now? If he did not also benefit from the money, you know, all sorts of terrible things.
You're saying that's not the point. That's what you're saying.
That is not the point. We should talk about what this expose that this man has brought out. How do we investigate it so that we can prevent this kind of thing from happening again? But people are not talking about this. I think we are going to get to a stage in this country when armed robbers, they will appear in court. And the witness will come, and people will be talking as to the witness. Are you saying you have never stolen before? Why are you saying accusing this man of armed robbery? Because it is getting alarming. This man said that he was part of all this rot, of all these things that happened. And we are supposed to, you know, harness this opportunity to do a thorough investigation. If, for instance, somebody goes to court and say, okay, I witnessed this man, killed this man, and this person was now sent to life imprisonment or even to the gallows. And after some time, he now repented. He now said, okay, maybe even because the money they promised me that if I make this false witness, I will be giving so amount of money. They did not give me that money. So let me come out to say the truth. Are we now going to be castigating that person?
All right, then.
Why do you have to say your testimony? Mm-hmm. Let this man go to the gallows.
Okay.
Let us know our enemy. Our enemy is corruption.
All right, then. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Dede. Really appreciate your call. But so as to sort of try and make room for other people. I get the point he's making. Following Dr. Aluko, the former PDP chair in Ekiti, following his outing on Channels TV on Sunday night, there have been people who have been saying, why now? And there's an ulterior motive. But what Mr. Odedeyi seems to be saying is that, look, for the moment, can you just forget the messenger and look at the message? The message is $37 million US was given by President Jonathan to Mr. Fayose. Mr. Fayose has denied. Can we just investigate that and not bother about the motive for the man in coming out now? There are different aspects to this whole corruption thing, but because there's been a culture of omerta. I understand the mafia silence code. Somehow that code has been broken and people are singing like canaries. There's someone else on the good morning, Yakub from Dokemu.
Yeah, good morning, Shifiori.
Thank you very much for calling in.
Yeah, good morning to two white men in the studio.
Good morning.
I'm just Barrister Ufuyen, because when it comes to security analysis, we always try his best. God Almighty Allah will keep you going, sir.
Thank
you. Let me straight to the point, sir. Is it about the second gentleman who just said something earlier that Buratai was a professional
soldier?
Professional soldier, rather. That
that does not mean the remaining people, the people that succeeded then, they are not professional. They are also professional because before you ascertain a general position, you can go to a lot of systems of programming and training.
You should be a highly trained person.
Problem, the only problem there is that the leadership then, the leadership I'm talking about is president then. The body language of president does not send a message to them that they should go to work from them. Now that the President Muhammadu Buhari is a I'm as a fear now. Who is that a general who will sit down in Abuja and direct people to go to war front that will not join them? About the Ekiti Gate, sir, let me just say something straight and forward, sir. You see, that gentleman that spoke earlier, he said something that I really like. But Chief Yori, apart from the governor, Fayose now, the remaining people that is involved in that by that quagmire, they are not enjoying immunity. Let this man, who the man that is giving testimony, he ready to go hard, he ready for the consequences. Let the remaining people that don't enjoy the immunity, they should face the law. Because if they don't face the law, all this kind of thing will be continue happening and then nothing will happen. Thank
Indeed.
You.
Thank you very much for calling in. Indeed, rightly observed. And the way things are going on now, I wouldn't be surprised if they come up with something similar to that. Because at the end of the day, we need to get traction with this whole thing and begin to show some results. But the danger, of course, is that the results must have emanated from due process. And that's where things slow down a bit. You're a lawyer. You're also a security expert. I'm happy that you, on the one hand, one half of you knows how to investigate and locate where there's a problem. Now the lawyer part of you now begins to look at how you can throw all sorts of sansan, all sorts of rule of law, sansan on top of the thing.
That is
and
where
then make sure that depending on how you want to go this morning.
Well, it depends. Yes, I agree. But you know, there's what to call a tainted witness. And that is where I see Aloko having some little challenge.
Because at the end of the day, what the government
will do is to make him a prosecution witness.
That's
that is what would happen now as it is. If eventually an investigation is conducted, some are indicted in the investigation report, had to prosecute. I'm just telling you.
But so far, this morning, I spoke with Dr. Tope Aluko about half an hour before coming on this program, and he said that no investigating agency has gotten in touch with him. Not SSS, not DSS,
I'm just telling you what.
That is what I will expect that is, the government to do now.
But
now,
as of...
You understand? Protect the man.
45 minutes ago, nobody has neared him.
They say the reason is also you don't also just jump at this type of thing. Don't forget that, number one, whether it is true or not, PDP sees him as an aggrieved person. All absolutely true.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. As far as I'm concerned. Now that you were there, you came out to speak the truth in court.
Yes.
Now, yes, we are talking about leaving the messenger and attending to the message. While attending to the message in the course of prosecution, the messenger will come in.
Because
and the messenger will be seen as a tinted world.
Because investigators like to look for motives.
And that's thank you.
Behind the whole thing.
Thank you. Because don't forget, this is a criminal thing.
Yes. George, good morning and thank you for holding on.
Good morning, Uncle Yuri.
Good morning, sir.
First of all, let me agree with Mr. Ofoyetan on the need for the president to use the money that is recovered instead of keeping it. That's in the right direction.
You also have your apprehensions?
Yeah.
For much later on, if we start to stockpile our gains.
Yeah, you should deploy the money to use
specific projects.
To serve the people. I'm happy he has already said that he's going to use that money to implement the 2016 budget instead of borrowing. So that's in the right direction. Then coming to Ekiti State, Uncle Yori, in the past few days, I've been taken aback by commentaries I hear from people that are otherwise respected. You hear them saying, don't mind that man. It is because he wanted something, he did not get it. That's why it's not.
He was supposed to be, we're expecting to be chief of staff.
Chief of staff.
I'm talking about Dr. Aluko now.
Yes, he was going to be chief of staff, allegedly. And yes, because he was thwarted, he's now coming out like this.
Yes, in any situation, Uncle Yuri, the truth has to come out in one way or the other. And it is coming out for the benefit of Nigerians. Could you imagine if this man had said what he said last Sunday during the tenure of President Jonathan? What would have happened to him? Would he have even had his way? And this is the right time for it, and this is the time it is coming out. We all know that what happened in Ekiti was not an election. Video clips were showed. What the man was saying, we are seeing in the video clips. And somebody is sitting down somewhere saying it's because he wanted something, he did not get it. Yes, he wanted something, he didn't get it. He has the right to be angry. But what he is saying, is it false or true? That's the question.
Okay.
And it is the issue we should be addressing.
Thank you very much, George. Really appreciate your call. I don't know, gentlemen, if you, I think you were speaking about that it's possible to actually separate the message from the messenger. Yeah. But then that's where politics could also now begin to come into it, right?
Yes, very well.
Because we're talking about the military and the military being used, and Tony had made the observation, astute observation, that when security and politics begin to make like they want to collide, everybody just take over.
Mm-hmm. There will always be conflict. Exactly. There will always be conflict because politics is never the friend of security. Security, incidentally, wants to be on its own because security wants to take certain decisions that may adversely affect politics, especially politicians and their constituency and their religion. And if possible, some of the things they hold tenaciously. Security wants to say, look, we have to do this for the overall interest of the people, and politics want to say, no, I have a constituency. Yeah. I'm responsible for this constituency. You can do it to every other constituency. Don't do it to my own constituency. Now that is where the conflict comes in. And that is why in most cases we advocate that, look, the military we have is not as if they are not professional. Like he said, to become the chief of any chief at any level, even to attain the level of a colonel, from major and above, you must be lettered.
Yes.
You must be very good. You must be versatile.
So you're highly trained.
So you're highly trained.
And then in spite of that.
So the issue is that it's not because they are not well trained. It's because the leadership also makes a big wall of difference.
Thank you very much. Ilo from Sokoto State, good morning and thank you for holding on.
Good morning, my uncle. Good morning, my elder over there.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Please go ahead. I won't interrupt you anymore.
Yeah. My own contribution is that... okay. My own contribution about what the lawyer has said, that the lawyer over there...
Mr. Foyeton.
About the Mr. President. So the money he gets, let him use it for the... We're problem of the country. You know, we are in another situation in this country now.
Okay.
So we have to use that money. You know, only God knows tomorrow. We don't know where things are going on. So we don't know tomorrow. Let's use the money. We're in another condition in this country. We need something to do about the money.
Yeah.
Instead of having to give the money as Obasanjo has did, when this government come and cop all this money, you know, let's use the money to know where we are now. You know, we are in another condition, especially in Sokoto City.
Okay.
The people are there suffering because of things are very difficult, you know?
Thank you very much, Ilo. Mr. Ilo from Sokoto State, thank you very much. Moving to Tony Ofoyeton's corner, that look, whatever money we're getting, can you begin to use it on behalf of the people now? Because as Mr. Ilo put it, nobody knows tomorrow. And that goes to show me here that the extent of the problem is, as you have said, it's so big that there are people who are apprehensive that can we get to the end of this? And while we're at it, if you go and stockpile money, God forbid, somebody should come on that isn't a Buhari type of a person. I'm an incurable optimist. I'm just hoping that after this, Nigerians will not tolerate somebody to come in and preside over how to share money or make it easy to so do, according to allegations that we're dealing with now.
We have a problem at hand now.
What is it?
The problem is financing 2016 budget.
Yes.
It is a common knowledge that the Nigerian economy is in a state of comatose now. Mr. President has just said it, that whatever he recover is going to use it to finance
the budget.
The budget that is not going to go on borrowing.
That means that
because that will take us back.
So there's very little wiggle room. He must recover.
Exactly, and plow the money back into the system. Yes. So I want Nigeria to give him support, to support him. You understand? You have said it, and it's a man of his
Nigerians
ways.
Most Nigerians do support, but there is also another...
We should be patient.
There's another segment that is saying that it is vindictive, it is politically motivated, it is one-sided, you're putting all your eggs in one basket, there are other jobs to do. So there's a sizable portion saying that as well.
Whatever Mr. President is doing is not restricted to a particular area.
Let me take our last caller. That is Mr. Oladejo. Good morning, sir, and thank you for holding on.
Hello, good morning, sir.
Thank you for calling in, sir.
I've been trying really so hard to get through, but thank God today I was eventually get through today. I really like the program.
Thank
you. My own contribution today is that the money recovered from those people, like Mr. President said, should be added and to implement the economics.
Okay, they shouldn't save it for a rainy day.
No.
No.
It's not saving it. Because we are in the mess now.
Oh, dear.
And we need to quickly change a lot of things in our economy to make it. A lot of people out there are not working.
Okay.
And about the issue at the Ekiti State, everybody know what happened in Ekiti State. It's only a day.
Everybody knows what happened in Ekiti State.
We only count in a day.
We have to wait on the investigative panel.
We have limited time.
Okay.
Let's watch.
Okay.
Good morning.
Well, thank you very much for calling in. Interesting. Everybody knows what happened in Ekiti State. Yet all the parties are denying what everybody purportedly knows.
Is he recording?
Anyway, let me.
Even that word, the way he started the sentence. Anyway, let me. Anyway.
I didn't want to. We have overflowed the Ekiti.
Yes, but in rounding off now.
Yes, in rounding off, I think I want to just plead with the president and the economic team. Because like somebody said, Nigerians are not finding it very easy. In trying to finance the budget, 2016 budget, I've had several different types of taxations, charges, and the like. All on one individual. If you want to protect the people, you should protect the people in all its ramifications. Because if you are giving a man 18,000 naira every month, and you ask him to pay 50 naira for out of those 18,000 as stamp duty, you also ask him to pay tax out of it, the landlord will come out and collect his own, the transporter will come and collect his own, medicals will come and collect his own, and you are talking of that man surviving. God forbid that he dies, so you may not have somebody to rule over.
I hear you. The fight against corruption.
Yes, sir.
They should not let up on it, or can they take surface more? What do you think?
The fight against corruption, I want Mr. President to forge ahead.
Full blast ahead.
Full blast ahead. You understand? Because we are not talking of you and I today, or our children. Our children are close to us. They see what is happening. They know what we are going through. But our grand and great grandchildren, so that they will not step into this same thing.
And the military, you are thinking reprofessionalizing the military?
They are on course for now. The military, as regards professionalism, they are on course. I can hit my chest.
So we can be hopeful. Thank you very much, Colonel Michael Abiodun Oladeji, retired, for coming on the program.
Thank you, sir.
Barrister Tony Ofoyedon, DG International Institute of Professional Security. The man is a security consultant. He's also a lawyer. Two of them. Sometimes. I'll see you tomorrow, God being my help. I am Yori Folani. Bye-bye for now.